Hi, everyone. My name is Priyanka Chaudhary. Today in Analytics in 15, we'll be discussing about ingest, manage, and analyze data with central governance. So let's see what is the agenda for today. So our focus will be Redshift cluster. Basically, we'll be discussing what is Redshift in the first slide. And then we're going to discuss about our new features, which launched just last year. Number one is streaming ingestion. So now Redshift can ingest the data that we can ingest the data directly to the Redshift. So we'll be doing the demo for that as well. And then we'll be discussing about Redshift data sharing with Lake Formation. And then there will be a small demo on that as well. And the last, not the least, is the Redshift dynamic data masking, which is the new feature which launched on the, notified on the last reInvent. Let's start. So let's focus on what is Redshift exactly. So Redshift is a solution for data warehouse in AWS, which is cheap, economical, and which can provide you lots of capabilities, like you can ingest the live stream data, you can ingest any application log, transactional logs, and now lots of features, like you can do the data sharing, which we're going to discuss in the next few slides. There will be zero ETL integrations as well. So you can do powerful insights basically with a couple of clicks. And that's it. You can visualize your data, and data can be of any size, and no infrastructure management. So that is the key point over here. So now you can do the work without any infrastructure management. You can securely share your data from one Redshift cluster to other cluster. So that is the new capabilities which we'll be discussing for the Redshift cluster. Now let's go to our Redshift streaming ingestion. So how Redshift streaming ingestion changed the picture, which was happening earlier. Earlier, we used to stage the data in S3, and then we can push the data through Kinesis Firehose to S3, and then you can copy the data to Redshift. But now, with this new feature launch, you can directly ingest your data to Kinesis, and then you can directly push your updates to Amazon Redshift cluster directly. How it's going to be happening is because, like, now your materialized view, you can create a materialized view on top of your Kinesis stream, and that can get the updates directly, and you can push the, you can see the changes in your data on top of like a Redshift cluster automatically in real time. So it's close to like a few seconds, you can see the updates are happening. So we'll be seeing this in next demo. Let's go to the demo. Time's sake, I have already created one Amazon Kinesis stream where we will be passing some data generator data. And then this data will be used for updating our materialized view. So for the sake of time, I have already created one data generator already with Amazon Kinesis data generator. Let's send some data over here. So meanwhile, let's create the materialized view and see how the things works. So let's go to the Redshift over here. And here I have already created one producer cluster in Redshift. And let's go to the query editor really quick to create our materialized view. Okay, I do have my queries already popped up over here. So let's go and create the, so first step we will be doing, we'll be creating one external schema so that, and with the Kinesis IAM role defaults. So let's create this schema first. All right, this query is successful. And then we'll be creating a materialized view. And this data which we are working on is all about like all the EV related vehicles, how they can go and check the where the stations are available in Austin. So that's the data we are using over here. So that's why the name EV station data extract. So here this is the Kinesis stream, which we already created. We are using that particular Kinesis stream to create our materialized view. So let's run this query really quick so that we'll see some magic over here. Okay, so this materialized view is already being created. Let's do the query really quick. There should be no data as of now, since it's gonna take like few seconds to pop the data. Now let's see how much data is already being sent to our Kinesis stream. It is already 5,400 records already being sent. We need to wait a little bit over here since we just created the stream. Okay, now you can see that the data is getting updated over here. So now, since we started the materialized view, it was zero, but it is connected to our Kinesis data stream. So EV stream data has the data now. So now you can see the records are popping up with all the details which we were talking about. All right, this is all about our ingestion demo. And let's go over to the slides pack. So let's go to our next topic since we already saw that how materialized view is getting updated. So next, let's go to our next topic, that which is like Redshift data sharing. And here, what we're gonna discuss, now it's a new capability which is still in, not in GA. It is still will be launched soon. But now Lake Formation can be used for sharing your data. You can centrally manage granular access to data access. To data consumer services. You can improve your security and governance with row level and column level granular permissions. There will be no need of any scripting or any complex mechanism to do the data sharing or to do the maintenance of governance. So now you can leverage your existing AWS Lake Formation services. You can leverage their central account to control all the data sharing with Redshift. You can also create like multiple policies with which is the capabilities of AWS Lake Formation, and you can use those for your Redshift data sharing as well. So that's a game changer, isn't it? So for the demo, how are we gonna do that? So there will be a producer account, which will be there will be a Redshift cluster created on top of that. And then our plan is to share that with our AWS Lake Formation account, which is our central governance account. And once the data, our Redshift data share is happening with our data governance account, then from here, AWS Lake Formation will play the grant and the grant permissions role, and then we'll be sharing that data to the data consumer account. So that is the plan for our demo. Let's go to the demo really quick. So for the sake of this demo, I've already opened up three of my accounts, and the three of the accounts which will be playing the role of producer, consumer, and the central accounts. Here today, I'm going to use 7973 account as a producer account. And there is 1257 is our central governance account. And the third account is our consumer account. So let's go to our producer account first. And let's go to the Redshift cluster, which is already being created by myself for the demo. So here, the first step, what we need to do is like go to data shares over here. And let's connect our database. I have already had the connection strings already, so that we can do it really quickly. Okay. So you can see like some of the data share has been created by myself, but let's create a new data share over here. And let's put the name demo account share. Okay. And this is dev, and we need to make sure that we need to make sure that it is not publicly accessible. And now let's add our objects, which we want to share. So we do have a public schema, which I'm gonna use it. And I'm gonna be using all the tables and views. Let's add it. And I want to only share these data to the other account. And let's put the other account number. So since our central account number is this one, so I'm gonna copy this account number from here, and we're gonna put it here. Okay, that's it. Let's create a data share. So it's taking some time, and now it's already created a data share. After this, let's go to data shares here. And then we can see that it is needs some action to be taken. So let's do this action really quick. So we need to up authorize this data share. Okay, so the first part is complete. Now our producer account has already created a data share for our central government account, governance account. So let's go to the central governance account over here. So let's go to our Lake Formation page over here and see our demo data share. So now what we need to do is we need to use Lake Formation function here. And there is a new feature over here for data sharing. There we need to accept the invitation. So let's accept this invitation really quick. Okay, yeah, we have done that. And now it's asking me to create a database, which is demo share database. I'm keeping the name same so that it is easily referenceable. And we'll be creating the database. So now the database already being created. Now we need to pass on the right permission so that we can share this database to our consumer account. So let's go to this and do the grant. Here, I'm gonna put my consumer account information, which is this one. And I'm giving the app only describe permissions and grant it. Now let's go to the database again, since we need to do the table level permissions as well. So we're gonna do the grant. And same thing, it will be for external account. So let's put this account over here. And then let's see the tables. Yes, so we can see all the tables. And I'm gonna put the same permissions, describe, select, and grantable as well, select and describe, and do the grant. Okay, so we have completed our second step that from central account, we have shared our database and tables to the consumer account. And now let's go to our consumer account to see what is happening over there. So this is our consumer account. Let's go to the Lake Formation for this one. Okay, so here we have this database already present, which is great. And we can see the database is already there. And after this, we need to follow some steps so that our Redshift cluster can use this database and we can run some query on top of that. So let's go to our Redshift cluster. Okay, so we do have one consumer cluster already opened over here. And let's go to the query editor really quick to run some queries. So once the database is already being shared and granted to our consumer account, now let's create the database on top of our database shared. So we ran this query to create this database, which is the shared database from the other account, from the producer account. And now grant the access to our user, which is running the query. Right. And now we need to update one connection so that we can use our IAM authentication so that my user can run this query really quick. All right. So we can see some of the data will come up in our results section. All right. Yeah. So we can see that our data is already present over here. So this data is being shared from our producer account to central account. Central governance account, and then it is being shared from central governance account to our consumer account. So that's it. That's how you can share your data securely, and you can use the Lake Formation to do the grant access, and you can even control the row level access and column level access with this. That's all for this demo. Let's go back to the slides again. So today we learned about like how we can share our data from one account to the other using the central data governance account. So let's go over to the last topic of the day, which is that Redshift dynamic data masking. This feature is still not GA, but will be available soon to everyone. But for this sake, we just need to provide you information that Amazon Redshift will support dynamic data masking as well. So you can easily protect your sensitive data by managing data masking through your SQL interface. You can easily data mask and modify your sensitive data or PII with the fictitious content. And you can restrict different level of permission to mask with the rule-based access control. So today we learned about all three features. There is a lot of things are coming with Redshift. So keep learning. And we do have some additional resources over here, which you can refer for all of the things which we have presented today. So thank you. I hope you learned something good. Thank you. Thank you so much.